let's look at the properties of logarithms. Being that logarithms are inverses of exponents, you'll find that these properties act very similarly to those that you would find with exponents. The three properties are the product property, which says we take the log base b of xy, the same thing as taking log base b of x plus log base b of y. The quotient property says if we take the log base b of x over y, we will get the log base b of x minus the log base b of y. And the power property says we take the log base b of x to the power of y, we will get y log base b of x. Log base 5 of 2 plus log base 5 of 6, since they both have the same base, log base 5, since we're adding each log, we will multiply. Simplify this, log base 5 of 12 plus the log of 5, since we are adding, becomes the log of 4 times 5, or the log of 20. Log base 3 of 20 minus log base 3 of 4. Since we are subtracting, we'll keep our log base 3, and it becomes 20 divided by 4, and again simplify this, it becomes log base 30 of 5. Log base 4 of 32 minus log base 4 of 16 becomes log base 4 of 32 divided by 16, which is simplified to log base 4 of 2. Log base 2 to the 6th becomes 6 log base 2 of r. In reverse, if we have k log base 3 of 4, that can be written as log base 3 of 4 to the k. You can also use multiple properties to expand the logarithm. For example, log of 3r to the 4th. This log has an exponent and it has multiplication. So what we will do is we will separate the multiplication by doing log of 3 plus log of r to the 4th. With the exponent that we have here, we will rewrite log of 3 plus, bring our exponent to the front, 4 log of r.